Okay, good morning, children. How are you? We are enjoying the holidays. Not only the holidays, we have to enjoy the lessons through online also. So, I am Nagaraj Shekhar, physical science school student. Now, I am going to teach you about optics in 8th class. Okay, so in 8th class, we are dealing only with the plane surfaces and also the reflection of plane surfaces. Okay, so now let us see what is the optics and how the optics developed and what are there in the optics lesson. Let us see. Okay, now I will show you some important slides. Please go through them. First, what is the meaning of optics? Let us see. Optics is nothing but it's a study of all the things what we can see, that is called optics. Okay, now let us see what is the optics and how the optics developed. See, optics is a branch of physics which studies the behavior and properties of light, including its interaction with the matter and the construction of instruments that use or detect it. What is this meaning? Optics is the branch of physics that studies the behavior and properties of light. Behavior and properties. What is the behavior of light? What are the properties of light? These are the important points to be discussed in this optics, including its interaction with the matter. It's somewhat higher, interaction with the matter and construction of instruments. Some optical instruments are there and the use to detect it. So first, let us see, the word optics comes from the ancient Greek word optike. What is the meaning of optike? Appearance or look. So optics, whatever, see, mirrors, lenses, whatever we use in optics, we use to look them, okay, look through them. That is optics. You know, who is the father of optics? Actually, optics is not a branch invented by one or two scientists. There are so many scientists contributed themselves to know the optics, to give the topic of optics. But father of optics, but one important person who did a lot of work on optics is Mr. Alhazen. Actually, it is very hard to pronounce. Elbin Al-Haytham. This is the one important person who studied the optics. So now, what is the what is his contribution to optics? Why he has named as father of optics? Let us see. Actually, before Alhazen, people believe that light comes from our eyes. Light comes from our eyes and it falls on the object so that we can see the objects. But he simply opposed that idea, and he gave the correct definition of reflection and also the refraction, so that the entire optics enter into a new system. So actually, he is the Muslim scientist, made great contribution to physics, mathematics, astronomy and optics also. A Barsa, he died at 74 in Cairo. The most important book written by him is Book of Optics. Of course, students, if you can find this book, you can also go through this book, you can read this book. It gives a lot of information about optics. Okay, right. So optic has mainly two branches. What are they? Geometric optics and physical optics. Geometric optics and physical optics. These are the two important branches of optics. What are these two? What is the geometric optics? Actually, geometric optics means what we know about light. Actually, we know about light travels in a straight line. Light has the properties of reflection, refraction, and how the image is formed, characteristics of image, and magnification, how big the image is formed and how small is the image is formed, relation between image distance, object distance, construction of optical devices. These are all comes under geometric optics. This is a very simple topic. Okay. Now, physical optics. What is the physical optics? It is somewhat very high topic. It deals about the wave effect, wave nature of optics, diffraction, interference. Of course, you don't worry about these words. You can learn your higher classes. Now, we shall confine our study to geometric optics. In this geometric optics, we are going to know about reflection of light. Reflection of light. This is the most important concept of light. This is the basic concept of light what we have to know. So what is this? When light ray incidents on a surface, it travels back into the same medium. This is the reflection. When light ray incidents, incident means it falls on a surface, then it travels back into the same medium. So let us see, let us explain in detail about this. So see here, there are two diagrams we are observing on the screen. So here, this is the light ray which is coming from a source. Source means, you know, we have so many sources of light. Either sun is a source, light, candle, bulb, these are all the sources of light. Whatever the source it may be. So light is coming from a source and it is falling on a surface. Whatever the surface it may be, it is falling on a surface. After falling on the surface, that is incidenting. Actually, we should not use the word falling. We have to use the word incidence. When the light incidents on a surface, what happens? It moves back into the same plane. This is called a plane. This is all called a plane. So it moves back into the same plane. Of course, if it moves to this side, it is called another plane. But it is incidenting on the surface and moving back from the same surface. So this is called the plane, same plane. This is entire called the same plane. Okay. This phenomena is called reflection. Okay. Now there are two types of reflections. One is specular reflection, or simply you can say it as regular reflection. Diffused reflection, another one is the diffused reflection, or you can also name it as irregular reflection. So regular reflection or specular reflection, irregular reflection or diffused reflection. What is the difference between these two? Let us understand. Now here you see, this is a surface, a smooth surface. What is the meaning of smooth surface? For example, you consider a glass, it is a smooth surface. Okay, when light incidents on this surface, then it reflects back. So here you can observe that for example this is a ray and this is going back, and this is another. So there is you can observe a regular pattern of reflection, reflecting rays. So this is called regular reflection. Coming to the irregular or diffused reflection, so here light incidents on a rough surface. What is the meaning of rough surface? For example, you consider a wooden block, it is a rough surface. You consider a plastic a table, it is a rough surface. Of course, it seems to be smooth, but there are very, 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 very minute particles are there, so it's considered to be rough surface. Now, when light ray enters, light ray incidents on the surface, so the reflection, you cannot get the reflected rays as in the regular reflection case. Only the thing is, here you have to consider the point where the light is incidenting. That is the most important thing. Okay, this is the irregular reflection. Of course, whatever the reflection we are observing in our daily life is mostly the irregular reflection. Okay, now let us know some important points about this reflection. So here there is a specular reflection describes the glass or surface or the mirrors which reflect light in simple predictable way. Means which we can immediately trace the reflected ray. This allows for production of reflected images that can be associated with an actual or exploratory location of the space. So here in this regular reflection, we can predict, that means we can easily draw the reflected rays so that you can clearly observe the image also. In case of diffused reflection or irregular reflection, describes non-glossy materials such as paper or rock. Such reflections from these surfaces can only be described statistically with the exact distribution of the reflected light depending on the microscopic structure of the material. Microscopic structure means every point of incidence counts here. This is the irregular reflection. Now, light, while it is reflecting, does it follow any rules? Does it follow any rules? That is the most important thing.
So before going to the rules which the reflection follows, we have to understand some important terminology. For example, these are the rays which are coming from the source. So these rays are called incident rays. And this point where the light ray incidents is called point of incidence. And these rays are going back. These are the rays going back. These rays are called reflected rays. These rays are called reflected rays. And this is the surface on which the light rays are incidenting. This surface is called reflecting surface. This surface is called reflecting surface. Now, at the point of incidence, we can draw a perpendicular to the surface. At the point of incidence, we can draw a perpendicular to the surface. These perpendiculars are called normals. They are called normals. Now, you observe that there is this normal. For example, this is a normal and this is an incident ray. So, this incident ray and normal, there is some angle in between the incident ray and normal. The angle in between the incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence, denoted by I. These are the most important things you have to understand and you have to remember while studying about the reflection of light. And now, this is the reflected ray. You consider this normal. So, the angle between the normal and the reflected ray, angle between the normal and the reflected ray is called angle of reflection. This is denoted by R. I stands for incidence, R stands for reflection. So, I is the angle of incidence, R is the angle of reflection. Now, let us once again, I will repeat it. The angle of incidence is the angle between the incident ray and normal. Angle between the incident ray and normal. Angle of reflection means angle between the normal and the reflected ray. Okay, so these are the angle of incidence and angle of reflection. Okay, now let us see what are the laws of reflection. Very, very important. The incident ray, normal, and the reflected ray lies in the same plane. So already I told you about the plane. This is the incident ray and this is the reflected ray. This entire region is called a plane. This plane is called reflecting plane. This plane is called reflecting plane. So the incident ray, normal, and reflected ray, they all lies in the same plane. That is first law. Second law, angle of incidence and angle of reflection, both are equal. This is the most important law of reflection. Any reflection, whatever the reflection it may be, it must follow this rule. Angle I equal to angle R. Angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Understand? This is the most important law. Now we are considering about the reflection at plane surfaces. Okay, so we shall discuss about this in the next topic. Okay, light. You try to remember this and go through the laws of reflection and reflecting surfaces and angle of incidence, angle of reflection, and what are the laws of reflection, angle of incidence, angle of normal, and the reflected ray. All are lying in the same plane. Angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection, and these are the laws of reflection. Okay. Thank you.